And we will pause for a moment to hear the starting lineup introductions. Welcome back, basketball fans. So you get a chance to see our starting rosters there. It looks like similarly built teams. We've got TAS with three seniors and two juniors in that starting lineup. And similarly, I think the Manila Bearcats bring two seniors to the squad and three juniors. So similarly built teams. Looking for a very, very interesting matchup here between two seasoned teams. Tell us a little bit about how they got here to this point, Mr. Blake.
Well, just looking back here through the results, it seems like the Bearcats have had a very hard-fought 6-0 challenge kind of coming through here. I'm looking at some of the scores here over the last 3 days, and some of their games have been quite close, quite challenging. So I think the Bearcats here are trying to continue here with a perfect streak. The Tigers here have actually picked up some big shooters there, coming in on a court here where the women have already kind of clinched the title. There's probably some pressure kind of built up for them. Wouldn't you say so?
Yeah, they come in 4-2, right? So we've seen them face some adversity throughout the tournament. Two losses. We believe that's one to the Manila Bearcats and one to the ISB Panthers. But they took care of the situation in the semifinals when they refaced the Panthers and really struck Tiger gold, I guess.
Can they strike Tiger gold twice?
That is the question. I mean, we will see. And we're here just for tip-off here. Certainly 8-minute quarters. not a lot changes in our championship game, although I believe the halftime is extended just a little bit more to give coaches a chance to strategize. So here we go. Here's Tip. Tip won by the Bearcats and organizing the offense, Jack Lopez, senior. Very nice assist from Jacob Thompson to a cutting out of Gamir for an early two for the Bearcats. Taipei swings to the three-point line. Number four regroups. Finds 10, Justin Lee. He sets the offense back up. He's been a cutter all tournament. Little floater. It's off. And a Bearcat rebound.
Zach, how important is it to try to get a good, strong lead here at the beginning of the game? What kind of impact does that have on a team?
Yeah, absolutely. Every momentum is a thing, and Bearcat area momentum seems to be built around a couple of early scores. One right there from Tarun Singh. So you're right. Early momentum, especially in a house like this, you can bring in the fans, you can shut them down. It depends on kind of that early lead.
If only I had that type of momentum whenever I play golf, it's always been a disaster.
That was today, right?
Oh, yeah. Let's try not to talk about that. Let's say folks on this game.
Another Justin Lee drive off the front rim on a reverse layup, and Jack Lopez pushes the action again. We're going to see Justin Lee look to cut and drive. He's done that all tournament. Really successful there for the Tigers at number 10. A Singh drive off the left-hand side of the rim. And the Tigers push the pace. Lee swings to number 8. 8 to Justin Lee again. Number 10. And this time he finishes. Finishes through contact as well.
Something that I have been noticing about the Bearcats over the course of this tournament is they've always been quite strong at moving the ball. Now, 3. It's off the rim, and now it's Tigers' play moving forward. But, Zach, can you talk a little bit about that? I mean, the kind of the passing plays here, more from the Bearcats, and seeing that there's a lot more at the moment, so a little bit more physicality here from the Tigers.
Yeah, you're gonna see it, because we see a lot of zone defenses, and to beat a zone defense, you have to get them out of position, as they just did there. Have to get them out of position. You can do that by swinging the ball around the outside of the zone, quick passes, making a zone respond and react to where the ball is really the most effective way to beat it. And that's what you saw. I don't know who that was, but one of the Tiger players sneaked behind that zone defense. Entry pass finished at the rim for two more. We had a 4-4 game. Just only 2 minutes or so into the game.
Now, is this a little early to be calling a timeout? Or is it just trying to get the teams and the players here a little bit more reset, trying to get the mentality back here?
Well, you talked about momentum, right? And this is a chance, you know, early 4 points, a response from 4 points. So Coach Hefty may be trying to slow the game down a little bit. Maybe, you know, packed house, lots of intensity. A timeout can really bring that energy down and allow a team to kind of regroup and organize. Let's see how they do.
Part of me kind of does wonder if part of that timeout was so that the referees could start to plan their halftime dance routine as well.
Do you expect a halftime dance routine?
I've heard some rumors going around.
Well, if they don't, then at the very least, you can step up. And
I'd be happy to.
I'm sure you would. So, a Singh corner 3, passed off to Nate. Nate misses. Slightly weak with that shot. And when the Tigers respond, again, you're going to see Justin Lee really organize things. Everything's built around his drive so far.
Justin just showing how strong of a player he is right there, kind of working through it.
He hasn't quite finished every player, take yet, though. And a Lopez take, a strong Alav Gamir rebound. And a battle for the rebound, and we've got Tiger ball out of bounds on the Bearcats. So, I think we're seeing a really organized game so far. I'm impressed with both teams' offense. They seem to be getting kind of the spaces that they want. Haven't finished everything yet, but let's see how that progresses. So, that's four. Declan Lee with a three-pointer off strong, and Nate pushes the pace up the floor. Little stop and jump shot. Some might consider that an air ball. I don't know. Might have caught rim there. But out of bounds, nonetheless, on the Bearcats and Tiger ball.
Now, just to make sure, can you remind me a little bit of this? As a golf and football enthusiast, the shot clock. So the shot clock only resets when it hits the rim. Is that right?
Yeah, we talked about it a couple times earlier in the tournament, but we'll repeat it once more here for you new viewers. I know this is the championship game. The 24-second shot clock, and that is only reset. It's only reset to 14 on an offensive rebound. Otherwise, it takes a change of possession to reset that shot clock. All right. 12, Victor Lee with a shot, a rebound. And so you'll see that 14-second shot clock reset. And 12 pushes the pace again, Victor, with a little jumper. No rim here, just backboard. And Tarun Singh pushes the pace for the Bearcats. Early drive, stripped by Justin Lee. He seemed to be expecting that drive. Stripped by Justin Lee, looks like the hip of Tarun Singh. Tiger ball. Benedict actually organizes the offense. Looks. Ball back to the top of the key. Swung around the baseline for a J. Off to the right, and a big Jacob Thompson rebound. Singh pushes pace. Thompson at the top of the key. A spin move. Hand off to Lopez. Johnny Toronto with a short shot. And here we go. Justin Lee pushes the pace yet again. Very strong, but no contact there, judged by the referee. And the Bearcats regroup for an offensive possession.
I feel like the Tigers can start to pull some of those plays through, and especially that physical push. And almost kind of the manipulation there of the ISM defense.
Yeah, they've been beautiful so far. They've really looked to push that pace. Excellent ball movement around the outside, and they find a cutting number 12, Victor Lee, for an up-and-under finish at the rim. 2 points, Tigers. He had a 6-4 Tiger lead. Jack Lopez swings the ball out to the top of the key. Transitions to Tarun Singh. Off back iron there. And another Tiger offensive possession. I've been very impressed with the Tiger transition of the ball around the outside of that zone, trying to get the Bearcats out of position.
The Tiger audience and fans here also seem to be the ones making the most noise at the moment.
You certainly have those loud, what are they, barrels or
the vuvuzelas. It takes me back to the World Cup.
A South Africa one, I believe,
yeah.
Right? I think they've banned them now.
Have they banned them now?
I don't know. I think maybe IASAS might be the next one to ban the vuvuzelas. Thompson hands off to Lopez at baseline. He finds a little bit of room, and they call a travel. And I guess a couple extra steps there.
The court suddenly covered the court, and you can actually hear the coaches now shouting words of encouragement to their players.
I have seen some coach shouting within this tournament.
As we all know, it's not only just intense for the players, but the intensity that does come from the coaches as well and the passion they put in. I mean,
certainly true.
These coaches have built these teams over quite a long period of time here, working with them sometimes for season after season.
Years. Yeah, it takes years to develop a basketball program. And certainly when you look at the Taipei Tigers, you look at more recent ISM Bearcat success, you'll see that they have not just teams, not just good solid teams, but programs. And programs are hard to develop. And so, despite some of the COVID situations, we see a renowned IASAS program from both the Tigers and the Bearcats.
And even with, let's say, the situation of COVID and sports kind of being put on pause, it does look like a lot of these players have have gelled together. Like, they almost look like they have been playing for years.
Yeah, it could be the case in Taipei as well. Long shot from Declan Lee. He's showing his range there. Clearly has some range. Long shot. And a quick Bearcat turnover leads to another Taipei possession. Declan Lee pushes the pace up. It's Victor Lee. Declan to number 11, Simon. Simon finds Declan again. Top of the key, Simon. So we get a Victor Lee three-pointer here. And Singh with a big board. There's 1 second left on the clock. I'm not sure if they got it up or not, but it's no good anyways. And we go into the end of the first quarter with a very low-scoring first quarter. A five-point Tiger lead. 9-4. Tigers on top. Very low-scoring first quarter. Why do you think that could be the case?
Well, I think it was a high-intensity game from both teams here. Ooh. Very high-intensity game here. And actually, the thing that I was most excited about was not just, let's say, the fact that both teams are showing up here, but that the first quarter ended with a half-court shot. I mean, I've been talking about it last time I was commentating. That was something I definitely wanted to see start to happen here. And it was actually quite a close shot there from J-Lo, a.k.a. Jack number 2 for the Bearcats.
And I'm not sure they would have counted even if it had gone in, but might have been beyond the whistle or the buzzer of the clock. But still an interesting shot nonetheless. We were hoping to see some sort of a halftime, half-court competition of some sort. We haven't seen that yet.
You got to wait till halftime. Like, it'd be great if we had a bit of a... I see. I recognize what you're saying now. Half-court contest. That's right. How could I forget? I do believe there is a car on offer. There are numbers hidden under seats. They might be presented here at some point. The referees have, as I mentioned earlier, been practicing their Macarena dance.
Did you happen to see the girls' halftime show? If you weren't here for that, you would have saw a Filipino folk dance that was actually taught to the entirety of the crowd. I got quite into it. So we might see that again at halftime. I'm interested to see what our administrators in charge have prepared today. Maybe Curry North or Swan, we might have to ask kind of what that halftime show is and give you a little snippet preview.
Or at least get the Jollibee half-court shot definitely going. Actually, you know, I might have to take a quick walk away from the table here and make sure that that's taking place.
Right. Back to the action. We got Tiger basketball inbounding. Looks like number 8, Aiden Chen, is going to find Declan, who will organize the Tiger offense and try to get that Bearcat zone out of position. Look to see how that ball swings around the outside of the zone. Here's Declan, finds Aiden Chen. Three again from Benedict Sashis, finds his range from three. We got an 8-point Tiger lead. See how the Bearcats respond. They find Thompson. Thompson swings back up to Cobra Maraju. A drive, a Jack Lopez drive, a little dish to Thompson. He finds Ryan Cobra Maraju for a little free throw jumper. It's off back rim, a Tiger rebound. And the Tigers slow it down.
Yeah, definitely the Tigers seeming a little bit more composed here so far.
They've run a nice offense. They've been able to get that Bearcat zone out of position, overcommitting, and finds it again for a bank shot off the backboard and a finish for Tiger Bucket. We got a 10-point lead. A Thompson drive and reverse layup cuts that lead to 8. 6:45 remaining in the second quarter. And certainly a low-scoring affair. So Victor Lee throws the ball back to Declan. Top of the key. Declan swings around the outside of the zone. Finds Justin Lee. Brings back to Declan. Declan for three again. This time short. They've reached that three-pointer consistently and shot it quite well thus far. Nate swings to Lopez, finds John Toronto, not often a three-point shooter, And I say that as he nails that one.
Actually, I do believe I remember you saying another player was not typically a two-point shooter for the Bearcats.
Yeah, both of the bigs of the Bearcats, both Thompson and John, have shown their propensity to shoot that three. That's the first I've seen from Toronto.
Definitely important for you to start to get them back in the game.
And responded to by Declan from three as well. And that was a deep three. He's shown his range multiple times in the first half already. A Jack Lopez drive, little jump shot. Falls to the wayside. Out of bounds after a hustle from John Toronto and Tiger Bell. 8-point Tiger lead, 17-9 here. And we've got a Tiger timeout. Interesting that it's a Tiger timeout here. They are reeling right now. I'm interested to see that they're the ones who must be. Coach must have identified something he needs to or wants to communicate immediately.
Now, for a timeout like this, would it be maybe trying to communicate to a player on the bench how they maybe would fit into a different formation or a plan of attack here moving forward, or?
Well, you can communicate with players on the bench anytime, right? You don't have to call a timeout to do that.
And actually, that is something I've been seeing, that typically during free throws, coaches have been pulling players to the side of the court to have a quick check-in, a chat. Is that a typical strategy then?
Yeah, very effective strategy, right? So instead of having, you know, four or five guys who are underneath the bucket trying to rebound a free throw or box out on a free throw, especially your guards, you might pull them in. You got a quick chance to have a one-on-two or one-on-one conversation with a playmaker or a decision-maker on your team. Really effective strategy. So you'll see both teams do that throughout the game. Look for it on the live stream. Player looks like they're running off the court. They're really just running to the coach to get the next call.
For those of you wondering about the noise, there's been a bit of a competition here in the crowd of flags and flag running right here.
Yeah, we've got Tigers running across. We've got Bearcats running across. Bit of a zoo. Taipei organizes the offense again. Throws the ball to the wing to Justin. Justin finds Benedict. Benedict back to Justin. And another Justin charge. This time they've got him with a block on a Bearcat. So I say charge. I should mean cut or a very nice drive from Justin. Again, showing that strength. Got a block on number four. That's John Toronto, just his first. And we've got Justin Lee heading to the line for two shots. His first one's good. Live ball here on the second. Let's see if he nails this one. And the second is good as well. He's shown an excellent three-throw shooter. Very nice form, so he'll try to get to the line multiple times, probably. We see a little chop here. It's extended pressure by the Tigers. Not quite sure exactly what form of extended pressure. Toronto surveys the field at the top of the elbow. Jacobo with a jumper. Short, unfortunately. And they find Justin Lee in the corner here again. Ball swung around the outside. Looks like five in. Looks like five out right now. Justin Lee with a little jumper. Very nice shot from the elbow. Nails it again, and we've got a 12-point Tiger lead, 21-9.
Yeah, definitely see Justin now. He's starting to execute those shots and suddenly sink those passes here a little bit more.
Absolutely.
A little unfortunate at the very beginning of the game, but now you can really start to see what it is.
Absolutely. And Toronto answers with a big three. So we talked about his three-point shooting earlier, and clearly he's proving me very wrong as I questioned some of that post shot, but again, so that the big man can shoot the three.
Yeah, don't worry, we'll replay some of those prior recordings and we'll play them back from a little bit later here.
He probably put it on his wall and said, Mr. T said I can't shoot the three, and so I've now made it a staple of my championship game.
I do believe I saw him pointing at you right after he shot and scored it. So.
And it looks like a little runner from Jacobo Lagdemel. A senior who I know had some unfortunate injuries throughout the season. So it's great to see Jacksonville have the opportunity here in a big, important IASAS championship game to get time after struggling with injuries throughout the season. Puts a little pressure on Ford, Declan, and I believe they've got a shifting of the steps there on Ford. A shifting of the feet, they call it travel, and it goes back over to the Bearcats here.
Yeah, and a big change here, 3 subs each from both teams. Definitely looking to get those tired legs off the court. Interesting to see how this maybe starts to change a little bit of the movement of play here.
Yeah, I mean, what you're also seeing, look at the Tigers pick up full court here. So, interesting to see. This looks like a trap. It looks like some sort of a half-court trap. We'll see how the Bearcats navigate around it. They swing the ball over. They beat the trap. Now what do they get out of it? A Gamir Lane. Off the sort of front of the rim and around off the backboard and in. And they see, show they can handle that Tiger trap. Tigers swing things around the outside. Find a cutting number 11. And that's Aiden. Oh, nope, sorry, that's Simon. And Simon has a little up and under. Gets the defender in the air. Contact and 2 shots now for Simon. Simon gets the first. And nails the second as well. We've got that brings us to a 7-point Tiger lead. And the Tigers decide to take off the press, take off the trap after that success for the Bearcats in the last one. They pick up half court this time.
So would you say that is a set play, that type of defensive move?
That type of trap, absolutely. Right? You'll see the coach even call it and say, you know, on a made basket, they'll say, as we make that basket, we get immediately into the trap. Usually, teams don't do that unless it's a made basket. So it's usually a response to a dead ball. Very difficult to set up a trap on a missed shot. Sometimes, some teams can do it, but it's not. Gamir gets to the free throw line on a drive and hits the first. He's got one more. And Arab hits the second. Long shot from Benedict. Nate finds Jack. The Bearcats put the pressure on. A Singh Jai. Count it. We've seen Singh Jai throughout this tournament. He's been very effective in transitional offense. And really, the Bearcats' bread and butter is that transitional offense on a missed shot by Taipei offense. So we see again Tarun successfully finishing a and one opportunity. He'll shoot one.
Unfortunately, not make the free throw shot there, but
gosh,
those shoes look good.
We did talk about his shoes the last game as well, and you know, apparel is such a functional element of this game, or at the very least, a decorative element of the game.
Well, I definitely think it makes you a better player.
Yeah, I agree. A 3 in the key call on number 15. That's Henry Lin, a sophomore. Normally, for your viewers who don't know what that call is, that's a 3-second call. So that's standing in the paint on offense for too long. You have to in and out of the paint within those 2 seconds. It resets every time you leave.
I'm not seeing that type of call being made too often here by the referees.
I think it's the first time because we've seen a lot of outside play by all teams. Not a lot of post play in this tournament thus far. And so you don't see guys camping in the paint for too long. But Henry certainly got called for it there. We get the Bearcats coming back with offensive possession. Thompson, top of the key. A A drive by Thompson. Strong drive. Aggressive drive. No good, though. And a Taipei rebound, and they'll push with Benedict. Benedict finds Declan. Declan brings things out, sets up a play, probably for himself here. Benedict with a little stutter step, finds Henry, 15, and a big finish from the sophomore, Henry Lynn. So not a 3-second call on that one, in fact, a 2-point bucket. Arad surveys the field, a drive. And they've got a blocking foul. Looks to be on for Declan Lynn. I'll confirm that. Look to be on four, and it is. That's only his first, though. And Gamir hits the first. He's got one more.
It's actually been a pretty positive drive here from the Bearcats to kind of make up that deficit that was left there. It was almost
We're certainly seeing a much more organized Bearcat offense. He hits both, and we've got a 3-point Tiger lead, 25-22, with 42 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Here's a Bearcat trap. Here's a Bearcat trap, and they've got an offensive foul. Looks to be on Declan. I believe looks to be on Declan Lynn. Would be his second if it was. But they might have got him for a travel instead. So no, not the second foul on Declan. I believe he's only got one. And Lopez sets the offense up. Swings to the corner. Thompson with a pull-up J. No good. And the Tigers probably look for the last shot here. We got 18 seconds on the shot clock, 20 seconds on the game clock. They can run this thing down and get a good one. And it's a Declan three, but no good. This gives opportunities to the Bearcats to respond. And a Thompson shot and Lillian at the buzzer brings the Bearcats to within 1 point. What do you think about the dynamics of that last play? It's quite interesting. We talked about the fact that Taipei didn't necessarily need to take such an early shot.
Absolutely. I mean, we've been having discussions nonstop about how to slow a game down, how to be a little bit more patient, and to make sure that you are the team that's taking the last offensive play, right? So I mean, maybe the Tigers there kind of let themselves down, and maybe they rushed it a little bit there and kind of, because they just felt that desperation, you could hear the crowd chanting down the final seconds of the game, and they took the shot maybe a little too early.
Yeah, it's a tricky situation because you want to take an open one if you get it, but it's got to be a good shot. It's got to be a very good shot. It's got to be a gimme. And if not, you want that last possession.
Now, right now, you might be able to hear, this is Mr. Andy Dutton here, starting to get the crowd a little riled up right here.
We talked about it earlier. I think we're going to see another Filipino folk song or dance. I'm not quite sure. But we'll leave you, and we'll let you watch this the action here with Andy Dutton and Taya Marshall at center court. And we'll take a break and sign this off.
Okay, number 6. first thing in the night? Okay. Cool. And we have one more thing with us today. Okay, thanks. We have one more thing. But we need to do an introduction first. Are you ready? Thank you.
halftime. It's just ending right here. We got about 30 seconds here until we start period number three. Period? Quarter? Am I talking hockey right here? I don't even know anymore. But essentially right now, we got coaches giving last little bits of advice. Everyone's kind of taking a knee, giving high fives again. Probably, oh, here it is. Fist bumps, high fives. Man, all these players are going to be having to ice their hands after this game.
Yeah, do you feel motivated, Mr. Blake?
I feel pretty motivated. I mean, the crowd's just ready. Like, we had someone playing the drums behind us here. But I must say, before the game gets on a roll here, I was getting some comments. The ISM golfers thread here was getting a lot of messages and comments on Andy Dutton's dance work and footwork out there.
Shout out ISM golfers. I would like to see their footwork and dance moves themselves. So we bring you back to action here. The start of the third quarter is a slow first quarter, but certainly not a slow second quarter. We got a 25-24 Tiger lead in Bearcat basketball.
Now, really important for ISM to make a big impact here, right?
Yeah, we've talked about momentum before. We'll see what kind of role they get out on. A big Demir rebound shifts the ball out to Singh. Thompson finds the top of the key. Surveys, drives again. Blocking foul on, that looks like number 7, Derek Lee. And he'll go to the line. No, sorry, it was 4, Declan Lee, which is his second. Still early in the third quarter, though, so nothing to be concerned about. The second foul there. Thompson shoots 2. Front rim's the first, off to the side of the backboard. And he'll follow up with his second free throw. Misses the second. Demir rebound. Shifts the ball back out to Singh. Demir drives baseline. Strong. Loses the ball. Going up. And we're going back the Tigered way. The Tiger way, that seems to be, sounds like the mantra of the basketball team, the Tiger way.
Probably, I'm surprised there's not a few Tiger way chants here happening. As we can start to hear the Tigers fans starting to raise the volume here.
The Tiger way is loud, if nothing else.
I think it's got to be the name. I mean, we should trademark that quick before Taipei takes that on for themselves.
All right, 7. Derek fires from 3, off left, and we get a corralled rebound. They send it forward to Singh. Euros to the right. Misses wildly, but Thompson rebounds, and he'll set things back up at the top. Lopez settles the offense. A Gamir drive. Thompson surveys. Thompson, but nails it. Very difficult jumper. Nailed from the short corner.
First time Bearcats are actually taking a bit of a lead.
That's right. That's right. They didn't notice that. 1-point lead for the Bearcats. We haven't seen that in the game. And a big Justin Lee take. He misses off the side of the rim. Rattles out. They find Nate, who drives center. Another Thompson shot. It's followed by a Nate rebound. He looked to go up there, and he got hacked. Foul on the wrist. 2 shots for Varaiva. He'll shoot 2. Back rim's the first. He's getting another shot here. Backrim's the second as well. And a Tiger basketball rebound. They put the ball back up to Justin. Very nice move. Transition offense by the Tigers. That is what you want to see from Justin Lee. It's clearly a strength of his.
They actually, the Tigers seem to have that, seemed to already have had that play set up.
You're right.
Justin was already there.
You're right. There may have been communication on the free throw itself. A Singh 3 rattles out. And a Jack Lopez, smallest guy on the court, rebound. I think he's the smallest guy on the court. Declan Lee might have something to say about that. The loose ball foul. somewhat loose ball foul on Tarun Singh, and we'll do side out here. No shooting foul. So with 5:37 left in the third quarter, we get a back and forth game now. Tigers go up one, Bearcats go up one, Tigers go back up one. A Thompson drive and spin, very nice move. Looks for Arad, excellent pass, finishes with an easy layup, and the Bearcats go back up one.
Almost looked like he was dancing on ice there, the spin that he was having.
That was beautiful, Mike. That was beautiful. Benedict drive and finishes at the rim. We're seeing great drives right now. Excellent. Excellent offense.
Very back and forth here between the two teams. Very competitive. Really exciting game here, folks.
Thompson surveys, uses his body again. Misses heavy. Misses strong, which is an apt description of Jacob Thompson. Strong. Finds Justin Lee. Justin Lee finishes again. And I believe we've got a Bearcat timeout. They're going to tie things over. It's the transitioning offense of Justin Lee that is really featured right now for the Taipei Tigers. Bearcat's going to figure out how to slow him down, look to take away that outlet pass on the missed shot.
One thing I do have to say about basketball shoes, though, and something that I've even seen a couple different Nike commercials as well, is like they always personify the well, maybe not personify, but they always amplify. Maybe that's the word I'm looking for. The squeak.
Ah, yes, right. I remember a pump shoe as well. I think that was if I remember right, those were the Reebok pumps. So the squeak, the pump, the. I mean, that's marketing 101, is it not, Mr. Blake?
I mean, every time I hear that speak, I hear dollar bills going off from the background, you know? It's kind of an amazing thing. Great marketing, great advertising.
We love the sound of a fresh pair of basketball sneaks. And, in fact, we see some fresh pairs of basketball sneaks out there. Who would you say is the most colorful team? And you know something about color as an art teacher.
As an art teacher, I'm quite the expert in color. Sometimes I don't see it so well. That might just be my age and eyes, but I'm actually seeing quite. I mean, I think it's the shoes by Tarun right now. The pink.
Tarun's seeing the pink. He likes the pink.
The hot pink right now seems to be not just for Tarun, but also even I'm noticing some of the Tigers players as well. Seems to be the color of choice for this tournament.
Toronto swings, surveys the field, drives, a kick to Nate, and Nate finishes at the rim. Another very nice example of Bearcat offense off of Toronto instant offense. They do struggle to pick up the shooters there, but luckily get a miss from Benedict. Thompson looks to Toronto. He's hit two earlier, misses this one back rim. And another outlet up to Justin. This time, no finish in the Thompson board. But that's another example of that transitional offense. The Bearcats need to watch that.
Yeah, it seems the Tigers have really kind of ground that into their team, really trained that into them to make sure that there's always one person running forward, even before the full play is ended by the opposition.
Yeah, clearly transitional offense is of paramount importance for the Taipei Tigers. Oftentimes you see that rebound, you got a quick outlet, and they're looking up to Justin. It's usually Justin Lee who's running that fast break, attempting to kind of get behind Bearcat defenders.
I do have a question here for you, Zach. The transitional offense. Transitional has been a word that you've been using quite a lot in some of the descriptions that you've been using here for describing some of the elements of this game. Can you go a little bit deeper?
I'll say transition offense is probably what I should be calling it. It's really what it is off of a defensive rebound. Can you beat a defensive scheme up the floor? If you can generate offense before a defense can get set, oftentimes you get to avoid sort of the organized defensive set of another team.
So like a bit of a breakaway.
That's right. But even, you know, not necessarily a breakaway just by yourself. Instead, maybe a 3-on-2 or a 4-on-3. Transitional offense is what we call it.
I mean, automatically for me, I suddenly start to think of the flying V here. You know? That's,
another hockey reference. Big Benedict rebound. He pushes the floor. This is kind of what I'm referring to with transition offense. But it leads to a Taipei turnover. And Lopez carries the ball back out. He'll organize himself. Toronto drives. and a Thompson jumper puts the Bearcats back up by one, 32-31, 2:53 remaining in the third quarter. We have back and forth game. Bearcats one, Taipei one, Bearcats one, Taipei one. Ball floats around the outside perimeter. Who is that? Who is that? First time I've referenced Justin Lau, but a very nice take. Strong move into the paint and a finish at the rim. And Thompson responds with his own strong take and a finish at the rim. So we're seeing now interior offense really be the difference maker in the game. It's drives.
Yeah, just cool runnings here from both teams. It's back and forth.
Very nice save from the Taipei Tigers. They'll regenerate their offense. Swing things around the perimeter. Try to get that Bearcat defense off. Another big board. And Lopez gets a steal. Finds Raya. Drives and a clean block from Victor Lee. Big clean block from Victor Lee. Benedict finds
a little bit from the blind side right there, somebody would say.
Who's the next?
They got a great block right there.
Excellent chase down block, reminiscent of John Morant and LeBron James chasing down and finding that ball at the rim. Really strong. It was a strong take, strong block. Coaches wanted contact, but refs have decided that they're going to let him play here today. The Bearcats will look to set up an offense. Maybe settle things down. Quite a bit of energy on the court right now. Thompson again drives to the lane. Having a difficult time stopping Jacob Thompson, really. And it's been the difference maker in the game. And he puts the Bearcats up by three. I know a Thompson score because I can hear his mom, Andrea Thompson, from across the gymnasium. Big Victor Lee rebound again. He's shown really a lot of success there. Boarding. Back rim three. Raya regroups. Lopez, top of the key, a drive, a floater, and short. And 44 seconds. Taipei will look to push. It's again a Justin Lee push. And they've got him for a blocking foul, a reach foul on the arm. Again, successful Justin Lee outlet pass, and he'll go to the line for two with 40 seconds remaining, trying to bring the Tigers within one.
Yeah, it definitely seems like the natural right there. I think it is number 10, Justin Lee, in here for the Tigers. It just really seems very comfortable out there on the basketball court, central to a lot of plays.
Yeah, a drive certainly is his natural basketball move. We have seen him shoot the three at times, but he's clearly what they call a slasher in basketball. Bit of a, I referenced John Morant earlier, maybe a Russell Westbrook slasher.
I'm trying to think of other movie titles here that might help to describe some of the players. I was about to throw out The Enforcer, but, I mean, that's just another great hockey movie.
That might be a better descriptor of Jacob Thompson, who we've seen be successful for the Bearcats. He's an enforcer both on the defensive side of the ball and clearly right now on the offensive side of the ball, making good, strong post moves. We go back to the action with a Bearcat lead by three, but our number 10, Justin Lee, set of free throws coming to try to cut that lead to one. Lee hits the first, brings them to two. A line. His second rims around and is good as well. And we're back to a 36-35 Bearcat lead.
Last 35 seconds here of quarter three, or as I like to say, period three, because I like to throw as many hockey references in here as I can today.
A Varia three rims out, and now we'll see the Tigers. We talked about this earlier. The Tigers slow things down, try to get one good shot. If you get an easy one, take it. If not, hesitate, pause, get a good one, and run that clock down. So you see they swing the ball.
It's got to be the new Tiger way right here. The new Tiger way.
And they get a tough shot. Oh, they get no shot at all. Justin Lee did throw it up, but as he caught that ball, his foot was on the line. And so we got 1.2 seconds left. Not a lot of time to get a shot up. We might see a long pass. We don't, and instead we see a dribble and a bit of a short heave.
Again, I was really had my fingers crossed there for another half-court challenge, half-court shot. I mean, are there any incentives here for any players or anything like that to score a half-court shot here? Or?
I don't think so. I think all the playing that we do now is amateur for the love of the game only.
A little bit like Rudy, right?
He was certainly not playing for any incentives whatsoever. That Notre Dame reference, though. But was playing with heart, which is what we've seen so far in both the Taipei Tigers and the ISM Bearcats. Go into the fourth quarter in about a minute with a 36-35 very tight championship game, just like we saw in the girls' game, although that did change later on in the fourth quarter. Very tight championship game, back-and-forth action, one-point game. And we'll take a little pause as things start in our fourth quarter. All right, welcome back. We wanted to give you a little taste of that ISM middle school gym atmosphere. It is rowdy. It is intense. How would you describe it, Mr. Blake?
Rowdy, intense, passion. This is just straight up passion here. And thank goodness we have the clap-o-meter up here in the corner to measure the volume here of the audience. And all I can say is it's definitely fever pitch right here. It's through the roof.
All right, we find Taipei Tigers organizing their offense around Justin Lee. Guard roll, hands it off to Declan. Late in the shot clock, what kind of look can they get? Declan heaves, it does make contact. Does make contact with the rim, but we got a pushing foul, loose ball foul, and a rebounder. I don't see a whole lot of foul trouble from either team. I think that makes for a really competitive, really interesting final fourth quarter. Not a lot of guys dealing with foul situations, so we get to see the best of the best here. Ball swung to Jacopo, who drives the lane. Contact, but no call. And we're going back the other way with a 4-on-5. Declan surveys. Number 8 over to Simon Lee. Simon looks at the cutter. And an up and under move, a very nice one, brings the Tigers back on top by one.
Again, I feel like the offense, the Tigers are making space there right in the center for one of their players to just slot into that space and that core pass right there,
yeah.
In the middle.
And it really comes from moving the ball around the outside of that zone. Justin drives again and finishes at the rim yet again. And we've got a 3-point Tiger lead. on both organized offense and some transitional fast break offense by none other than Justin Lee. Kicks to Nate. The corner. And Nate shooting to three. There's a three. That's a triple. And he brings us back into a tie. I think the first tie of the game, actually.
First tie of the game right here. I'd say this is turning into the court of dreams right here instead of the field of dreams here, people.
Nice Kevin Costner reference there for all you UV fans. But it's off the front rim and a Bearcat board. Another big Thompson Bearcat board. And we bring it back the other way for Bearcat action. And John Cabello dribbles around. Tiger defenders. Little sweep through. Up and under layup. And finishes, and we get a 2-point Bearcat lead. Simon Lee surveys. Doesn't look for his 3-point shot. Looks to cut. Finds an open 16, front rim, and Thompson board again. He has been a force on the rebound. Tarun Singh pushes the pace, goes strong to the bucket, gets a, what would that be, a blocking call, or just some form of a body action there. They call a push, and he's got 2 shots on the line. That is Tarun Singh's game.
I am noticing that there are a number of mops out here on the floor. Is that to soak up sweat? Is that to soak up moisture on the court here? I'm seeing a lot of, like, mopping of the court.
Mopping the court. I didn't even notice that. Yeah, it must be. You know, so this sweaty guy falls on the court. They need to then clean it up so to prevent anyone from slipping the next time around. I think it's just to get those few extra squeaks in here. That could be it. Keep a clean floor for a squeak. Tarun Singh hits the first. Puts the Bearcats up 3. And he'll go up for a second. 5:16 remaining in the fourth. Back rims it. We'll remain at 3. Benedict surveys the court. Hands off to Simon Lee. Simon finds Declan. A little four-corner action here. A handoff trying to get that zone to respond. Very strong move, excellent pass, and a finish by Derek Lee. Beautiful move from Simon Lee. He's got handles. Lopez finds Toronto. Toronto finds Singh, drives to the line. He's got another blocking foul, or another pushing foul, and we'll have 2 more shots from Tarun Singh. Tarun Singh has been getting to the line in the last couple of possessions. What do you think that's a product of, Mike?
Maybe getting to the line, I think that's a product of him pushing, and actually he's making the attempts to go in for the shot, but he's really trying to pull the foul.
Yeah, that's right. I would say, you know, the way he aggressively attacks the rim there, he is trying to finish, of course, but he is expecting contact. And that's what a good scorer does, a good slasher does. They expect contact, they finish through contact. And that's why you've seen so many 3-point and ones for Tarun Singh. He hits the first.
And also, I am noticing that I think on the scoreboards for all of you watching at home, you're not actually able to see the bonus. And right now, there is a 3-0 foul bonus in favor of ISM.
Right, so 3 fouls on Taipei. Still another one to go before we hit the bonus, but something to watch out for as we progress out through this fourth quarter. And we've got a 3-point lead. Singh hits the second. 3-point lead for the Bearcats. Let's see how the Tigers respond. Benedict surveys the field at the top of the key. Hands to 7. Declan off a screen. They have another Benedict screen. Justin hoists the shot. The bank is open. He nails it. Not the prettiest shot. Forced at the end of the start clock. But, hey, when it goes in, it goes in. Counts 2, just like any other shot. A handoff to Varela. And Varela finishes in the paint. Very nice Jacob Thompson handout. Justin Lee looks to finish again. Looks to push again. Kicks the ball out. And we'll slow it down here. With a Tiger offense.
both teams seeming a little bit gassier. It's been very quick, very back and forth. Definitely some tired legs out there on the court right now.
You might have saw it right there. Thompson tried to combat Lee at the rim and failed to do so. And Lee finished to bring the Tigers back to one.
Now, this is a little bit of a precarious situation right here for the Tigers. The bonus now for fouls is at four. If the Tigers commit one more, right, this is going to start to – what does that start to lead to?
Yeah, so as a result of hitting the bonus, so the next foul by the Tigers will put the Bearcats on the line. That is something to keep in mind, something to watch out for. Bit of an errant pass. An errant pass from the Bearcats leads to a number two – Benedict Steele, he goes up strong at the rim, draws Bearcat contact, and now he's got two shots. He hits the first, and that ties the game at 46. He can put the Tigers up one by hitting this. And he does.
Big play right there.
Yeah, 47-46 lead. Taipei, lots of time still left. 3:20 remaining in the fourth quarter. 1 point lead. That Tiger offense. That Tiger defense, rather, has forced the issue. Another steal. This time, not able to finish at the strike. And that is a rebound by strong Jacob Thompson. And as a result of that rebound, you talked about the bonus. Here it is. Here's the result of a fifth foul. That means Thompson, even though it was a defensive rebound, Thompson will go to the line. He'll shoot two. We're bound to see a relatively slow game in these next 3 minutes. So 3 minutes left doesn't always mean 3 minutes, Mike.
Now, will this be a tactic here for ISM to really start to push these sorts of plays to always be top of the line? Is that seems like a good tactic to me.
Certainly, but I don't think it's any different than their tactic the whole time. They've been pushing the pace of the game from minute one. Thompson's first is short and to the right. He goes to the line to tie it at 47 with his second.
Definitely a little bit of a hard knock life here from the free throw line for the Bearcats.
If we shifted to 90s songs now from 90 movies. But he misses the second as well, but a big board from Variety goes up, gets blocked both by the rim and by the Tigers. They're kicking out to a Jack Lopez three. Off to the left, front rimmed, and we've got a 46-47 game still. Another Justin Lee drive. Finishes at the rim. 3 point Tiger lead. 2:42 remaining. Thompson finds Toronto. Toronto's shot rims out. Very close. Halfway down. Finds Jack Lopez. His shot rims out as well. But it'll stay with the Bearcats. They're fighting hard on the offensive rebounding boards. And they'll continue to look to cut into this Tiger lead, which is three.
Definitely some set plays getting called out there by the ISM bench. We actually are quite close to the benches. We can hear these set plays being called out here.
A sing drive, finish at the rim, reminiscent of the sing that we've been referring to throughout the tournament. That is where he's best, is that slash and finish at the rim. Goes hard. It draws an easy two. Big state rebound there. Real 1 point game. Minute 54 left. That's still plenty of time. That's eternity in the boys' basketball game. Thompson swings right. Misses. No contact. And now we go back to the Taipei Tigers. Tigers call a timeout. They want to set something up here. We're down to crunch time. 1:45 remaining. And we got a 1 point Tiger lead. Mike, have you been in any of these athletic situations, competitions where you know, last game, championship games, what's your storied career like?
Specifically in basketball, I mean, you have to...
Not in basketball.
Oh gosh. Well, I mean, I do have a few good basketball stories. I mean, the best moment I'd probably have to say in my entire life, take me back to when I was 12 years old. I was missing the same shot all game. Coach said, pass it into Blake. He'll make this one with 5 seconds left on the clock. Ball gets passing me. Shoot the buzzer shot. Tie the game. Goes to overtime.
Wonderful, wonderful job. And then you never played a game again in your life.
Retired. You always end on a high is what I am.
Probably a good decision. Certainly not the same quality of basketball that we see in IASAS and ISM today.
Which is why I keep playing golf, because I've never been able to achieve any type of high there in regards to a score.
It's a difficult game. Okay, fans, I'm not sure if you can hear me at all. This middle school gymnasium is absolutely at peak volume. And we'll see a defensive set here. Taipei Tigers look to set up an offense. That's what that timeout was about, by the way. Was to try to draw up an offensive set that might work for them. They'll look to maybe use some time here as well, slow the game down, see what we have. Justin settles at the top. A drive, a kick to Simon for three. A little slant, and now the Tigers look to respond. They find Singh. A Singh drive, little jumper, and he finishes and puts the ISM Bearcats up 50-39 with 106 remaining. The Tigers slow it down, composed, organized, and looking for their own shot at Simon Lee again, this time short yet again. And now we've got an organized Bearcat offense. Singh slows the ball down. A Thompson screen, a Singh jumper, this one short, and an Eagle board. So 27 seconds remaining. We got a Declan and three. That one's short. So right here with the board, he finds Singh.
Tigers bench calling for full court press here.
And then we need to who finishes the two. A Tiger timeout brings the game to 52-39. ISM Bearcats. The crowd is quite intense right now. I don't know if you can hear us.
There's not a person sat down here right now. People are jumping up and down, singing, chanting.
13.7 seconds left. Again, that was an eternity in a boys' basketball game. Taipei will look to set up an offense. Very interesting situation here, Mike. So Taipei needs to decide whether or not they want to go for a quick two or try to challenge with a three. You see varying coaches with very different strategies. Oftentimes it might be a very quick drive, see if they can get something easy at the rim, and then put the ISM Bearcats on the line. Otherwise, if they get a drive and a kick, they might look for a three and tie it right now.
Well, if they're looking for someone to come in and try to make a buzzer shot right here, I mean, I could come out of retirement.
Fifth grade was a long time ago, so I think we'll leave you right here in the announcer's booth, and we'll see what the Taipei Tigers can bring to the action. And folks, we're going to let you watch this one. Not a whole lot of commentary. I think the action speaks for itself. Tigers set up a little screen situation. They got Declan Lee out at half court. They might run some action off of him. I've seen him shoot long shots already. He can look to drive. They might look to find Justin for a quick slash and finish at the rim as well. It's Simon who finds Declan. Declan with a deep three to Simon. Simon misses. And another rebound. With 5.1 remaining, it looks like the foul happened on the rebound itself, which will send just determining who's shooting here.
It's a Toronto.
It looks to send. Still wondering who's shooting. We're not quite clear on it. I don't think the referees are clear on it yet either.
Look like Cruz can be taking the shot.
Toronto is going to the line, so it wasn't made with the original rebound. It was a handoff to Toronto. Toronto can all but put this one away with 1-3 throw. He's got two. He nails the first. Puts ISM up four.
Now, what are the chances of the Tigers being able to bring back?
This one would pretty much ice the game, although there's still 5.1 seconds left. And he nails that one, puts the Bearcats at 5 points. We're going to see a very quick hoisted three. They're looking for a foul, but a little too much good. At the bathroom, Bearcats win. Bearcats win. 54-49. Bearcats win.
Now, you can probably see this is home right here, but the fans have stormed the court here. Now, normally, you know, security be stepping in, taking people off, but I think we've got the right things here happening. Such an amazing thing to be able to see this. People coming together, celebrating.
Students, fifth grade students, high school students, the team somewhere in the middle of that. Just want to highlight here, such an amazing game from the Taipei Tigers. They should hold their heads high. Very, very strong Taipei effort. Of course, the home team was victorious. We got an ISM victory.
And actually, I believe this makes they've held on to the championship.
As strange as this sounds, they are back-to-back champions. Now, unlike pretty much any other back-to-back IASAS this year, the last time they won was pre-COVID 2020, about 3 years ago today. Maybe not today, but 3 years ago now. And thus, this is their second in a row, back-to-back champions. I believe only the third time in Bearcat history that they've won a basketball, men's basketball championship.
So what you're also seeing right here is the ladders are being brought out. I think the ceremonial cutting of the net. Now, what can you explain a little bit of that history of the cutting of the net here, Zach? I mean, I don't think I've really ever done that. I mean, they didn't give me the net when I scored that buzzer shot.
They should have given you the net. That would have been the last time you would have had a piece of it. But cutting of the net, traditionally done, you'll get a piece of the net. Each person on the team will get a piece of the net. So they'll bring it down, they'll cut it up into pieces, and that's a sacred treasure that you hold maybe for the rest of your life.
Wow.
A bit like when you on the baseball diamond, you grab a little bit of the sand and you throw that in a little tub, or on the pitch, you grab a couple blades of grass and you say, this is the last time I might play high school basketball, which is the case for many of our seniors. Just a little shout out to Taipei seniors, Justin Lee, but a very nice game, Declan Lee, Derek Lee, and then the ISM seniors, only one on the team the last time that they won, and that was Jacob Thompson, Tarun Singh, John Toronto, Jack Lopez, Savan Malcumian, and Jacobella DeMello, and Ryan Kochamaraju. So a senior heavy team for the ISM Bearcats. And the last time that they'll probably play IASAS basketball on this court.
Well, we're going to let the fans take this away. We're going to let the players enjoy these last few moments here on the court, and we're actually going to be signing off here. So thanks so much for being with us. Thanks so much for watching IASAS Sports and Basketball here with us at ISM, and we wish you all the best. Keep it classic.